Jesus' name we pray. Our Divine Father, we are grateful because of the new thing you are doing now. The new thing you are doing is the old thing that has been there from the beginning. Father, to revive your truth, righteousness, and holiness in Christendom. Father, we are asking that the eyes of your workers, your ministers that are here will be open to this truth. And the eyes of your worshippers that are here will be open to know the type of ministers that are in the world today. God, I am asking that things will be righted, righteousness will return, clean workers, righteous workers will be raised up for you in Jesus' name. I give thanks to you for answering our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Pure Christian ministry in holiness revival movement. Pure Christian ministry in holiness revival movement. Three things we want to say here in summary. That in the world, in Christianity in the world, there is corrupt Christian ministry in many places. Corrupt Christian ministries in many places. But among us who have come to God in holiness revival movement, for you who come here, we pledge to give you pure Christian ministry. We pledge to minister to you according to the word of God, according to the pattern of Bible preachers in Bible days. And number three, we are now saying to our leaders that ensure that nobody in holiness movement, in any chapter or unit, any position, teach any other thing contrary to what we preach and teach. That the practice of the hidden, the backsliders, evil workers, which are being practiced around us in the world, should never come to holiness revival movement. Ensure that nobody in holiness movement is using salt to deliver anybody. That nobody is using apron in any move, any side, any chapter, any country, any unit, using apron and is saying it has power to heal, to protect, to deliver. It must not be seen in holiness revival movement. Handkerchiefs that you ensure nobody is propagating the use of handkerchief everywhere in holiness revival movement. Ensure that all this corrupt use of anointing oil, that nobody is using that to corrupt people, putting their faith to anointing oil roundabout, as is done in these corrupt ministers around us. That's what we are saying, that you put eye, that nobody should deviate, man or woman, from what we are doing, false prophecies. Watch out that no one, no woman should be prophesying in evil to deceive people, to destroy people. Make sure such a thing is not done. Amen. Let's render to the world pure Christian ministry. Let's render to the church pure Christian ministry, that the people that have run in here should have hope of eternal life. Matthew chapter 12, verse 33 to 35. Matthew chapter 12, verse 33 to 35. Either make the tree good and his fruit good, or else make the tree corrupt and his fruit corrupt. For the tree is known by his fruit. O generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. A good man, out of the good treasure of the heart, bringeth forth good things. And an evil man, out of the evil treasure, bringeth forth evil things. That's the world. A good tree brings forth good fruit, and an evil tree brings forth evil fruit. In the same way, a good Christian ministry that teaches the true word of God and practices the true holiness of God will bring forth true Christians. And also, an evil Christian ministry which denies the members the truth and are ungodly in their lives and character will produce fake Christians. Fake Christians. We insist. We insist on pure Christian service in Horemo to ensure our members make it to heaven, and we ourselves also. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15 and 16. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 15. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. The salvation of man depends on the truth of the word preached. Depends on the salvation of man depends on the word of truth, the Holy Scripture. It does not depend on the preacher per se. The salvation of your life is not in the hand of the preacher per se, but the word of truth. It is the truth that says. But then the preacher can play his own role too in the salvation of man. What role? He should present the true word to you. In the drugstore, you have the pharmacy. You come to the pharmacy. It's not the pharmacy that should cure your sickness. It is drugs that should cure your sickness. And if the pharmacy gives you the inappropriate drugs, are you going to be cured? No. As if, however much you take it. That is why Paul is saying here to Timothy, be careful. Be careful. Hold fast to the truth that I have taught you, that you have learned, that others in Christ have taught you to. Continue in this truth. You are preaching to other people now. The salvation of those people rests on the truth. If you continue in this truth, you will save them. As they hear you, they will be saved. Whatever is their sin, the word of God is like hammer. The word of God is like fire. It can break to pieces. It can consume the stubble. Preach the truth. And note also, you are supposed also to stand on this truth. Already you are born again, Timothy, but the final salvation has not yet come. Final in the case of the rapture, when you shall be leaving this earth to enter heaven. That time has not come. Final in the case of death, when you would die and then have to enter heaven. That time has not come. That's the final salvation. If you don't preach this truth, you will die and never go to heaven. If you don't preach this truth, the rapture will come. You will never hear the voice of the trumpet. That is what he wants, Timothy. And that's the warning to every preacher here. It is the truth, not yourself, not your senior pastor, not the general overseer, general or superintendent. It's not the one that saves, but the truth. Preach the truth. Don't fear man. Don't fear any authority. Otherwise, you will go to hell. If you fear any authority and refuse to preach this truth, you will be condemned to hell, and your congregation will never be saved. Listen, there are so many congregations in Nigeria today that not a single one of them will make it to heaven. Great congregations that are more than this number on Sunday for worship, but not a single person will go to heaven there. I'm telling you this. Why? The word of truth is not there. The word of truth is not there. Go and check all this water we pour inside the tanks. Go and see whether you find fish there. Will you find fish there? But it's water. Fish is found in water, but not this type of water. Not this water we put inside the tank. You're not going to find fish there. Fish cannot survive there. The heat of the tank, fish cannot survive there. There won't be enough oxygen for them. So fish cannot survive. Even if you put fish there, it will not survive. So there are churches. The Spirit of God cannot thrive there. Jesus is not there. Concerning the Laodicean church, I stand at the door. I'm not inside. I stand at the door. Jesus is at the door. It's not inside. So, it's not all churches. that can make it to heaven, that members can go to heaven. Not the pastor, not the member, not the pastor's wife, nobody there. Therefore, take heed unto yourself. Now, I talk to you on corrupt Christian ministry in many places. Corrupt Christian ministry in many places. Jeremiah chapter 23. I read from verse 14. Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 14. I have seen also in the prophets of Jerusalem an horrible thing. They commit adultery and walk in lies. They strengthen also the hands of evildoers, that none doth return from his wickedness. They are all of them unto me as Sodom, and the inhabitants thereof as Gomorrah. Come, with Sodom is the leader, the members will be who? Are you getting what the scripture is saying? The pastor is Sodom, the members are what? Sodom and Gomorrah. Is it where you want to be? Is it a good place for God? What is the plan of God? Or what was the plan of God for Sodom and Gomorrah? Destruction of fire. The plan of God for that church is destruction of fire. The plan of God for that your church, where the pastor is Sodom and you members are Gomorrah, is a burning fire, everlasting consumption. That's the word of God. That's the word of God. The prophets, they commit adultery, they walk in lies. And he says, therefore, thus saith the Lord of hosts concerning the prophets, behold, I will feed them with wormwood and make them drink the water of God. For from the prophets of Jerusalem is profaneness gone forth into all the land. From the prophets, profaneness, abominations have entered into the Christian society. Bishops, archbishops, they have spoiled the whole denomination, spoiled the whole system. They have abused Christianity. Very terrible. They sit as overseer. Daddy, 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 daddy has corrupted everything. Daddy has sold the people to Satan. Daddy has turned the faith of the people from God to the devil. The Lord said he will feed him with wormwood. The Lord said he will judge daddy. The Lord said he will judge him, pastor. And the members shall not escape, because they have not known his truth. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, hearken not to the words of the prophets that prophesy unto you. They make you vain. They speak a vision of their own heart, and not out of the mouth of the Lord. God is saying, don't hear those general overseers. God is saying, don't hear the voice of those pastors. Don't hear what they are saying. They are making you useless. All those prophecies are the imaginations of their heart. They are speaking out of the deceit of their heart to put deception upon your life. That's what God is saying. Oh, are you hearing? If you don't hear well, you won't hear it continuously in hell. You would think that inspiration is in the name. You would think that inspiration, anointing is in old age. How long you think that anointing is in crowd? How many people are gathered before him? Anointing is in influence. What great influence that person has over the world. The Lord said, don't hear that man. That's the voice of God. They say still unto them that despise me, The Lord has said, ye shall have peace. And they say unto everyone that walketh after the imagination of his own heart, no evil shall come upon you. That's their prophecy, prosperity. They say to the armed robbers, the Lord says you will prosper. They say to the harlot, you will need not. The Bible says God has taken away all sicknesses from you. You will never catch HIV/AIDS. And the harlot say, amen, daddy. That's what they're saying. They're making you foolish. They're making you useless. They're giving you wine to drink. You are like a drunken man, staggering on your way to hell. And you say you're a church member. That's what they have going on. A man in his sin. Yes. They make you vain. That's what the Lord is saying. For who had stood in the counsel of the Lord and had perceived and heard his word? Who had marked his word and heard it? Which one of them go to study to find out the mind of God? Which one of them? Do they have time to study? Is it not to wake up and come and be telling testimonies? That's what they do. He said, behold, a wild wind of the Lord is gone forth in fury. Even a grievous wild wind, it shall fall grievously upon the head of the wicked. The anger of the Lord shall not return until he have executed, until he have performed the thoughts of his heart. In the latter days, he shall consider it perfectly. I've not sent these prophets, yet they run. I've not spoken to them, yet they prophesied. Can you see? They went to start churches. You didn't even investigate it. Who is this man that has started church? You just followed. You go and sit down there, and you're clapping hands. You're laughing there as a madman. Did you know that man? Did you know the history of that man? Did you know where that man came from? Who trained up that man? Where was he from? The Jews would not accept anybody as an Israelite until they are able to trace you to your father's house. Even with they declared the freedom from captivity. Cyrus declared freedom that let the Jews go back to build Jerusalem. They checked records. Because there was register, every Jew that was born, his name was in the register to ensure no fake man shall come in. Everything was done to protect the seed of the woman that was going to come into the world, that no stranger should come in there. Everything was done to protect the nation of Israel, that no stranger should come in there. Strangers have come in, people the Lord has not sent. They have come in to start churches. They have come in and you're there. You're there, 15 of you. You're there, suffering. Suffering. You're 20. Or else the man knows how to do it. He's a magician. You have 200 now, 1,000. Okay, the man maybe has gone to occultism. You have moved to 1,000, 10,000. Oh, thousands. You are there. You have not traced that man. You have not studied that man. You have not checked up on the life of that man. You have not investigated that man. You have not found out clear. You have not prayed to God. Who is that man? I cannot give my soul to somebody. I don't know his history. Because my soul is precious. My soul is precious. A wise man does not sleep in every guest house, every hotel. Because what is this hotel? What is common about it? Is it safe? Are there thieves here? Are there kidnappers there? Have they arranged with any kidnappers? I must be sure of this hotel. That's a wise man. That's the word of God. But you will not follow it. You will not do it. So that's what God is bringing this thing to you. He said, If they had stood in my counsel and had caused my people to hear my words, then they should have turned them from their evil way and from the evil of their doings. Do you know where the mind of God is? Evil. For Jesus didn't come for anything but to deal with evil. Remove evil, good will take over. So it is sin. What Jesus came for? Sin. But are you seeing people getting saved from their sin under them? Are you seeing people coming out with clean testimonies? I was a sinner, I was this, I was that, and it is, and now I am saved. Are you hearing that? Or fake testimony? They go to fake it, they go to arrange it, and afterward you come to know that it's not like that. It's like that person who went to a madman in his community, a pastor in one of these places in Starap, in Plateau State. He went to get that madman and took him to Josh and shaved him. Bob, he said very well, and came to tell the church that the Lord, the power of God is moving. The Lord has delivered this man. The Lord led him to me. His madness is gone. See him now. And he brought the man. Maybe he said he will give him some money. He brought the man and shot him in the church. The people were clapping their hands. And when they finished, the man didn't understand what happened. He went back to his normal mad place. That's arranged testimony. Oh, you are deceived. Precious sister, deceived. Precious brother, deceived. Your soul is precious, but you're under deception. Power of hell has laid hand on you. You have been dropped in the den of the lion. A strong man armed is sitting at the gate. They say, you're a member of Catholic. You're a member of this church. You're a member of that church. No forgiveness of sin. No change of life. No righteousness. No holiness. No freedom from sin. And then you'll be there for 40 years. You're getting ready to die now. To go to hell. As usual. The Lord will show you mercy here. He said, I am a God. Am I a God at heart, saith the Lord, and not a God afar off? Can anyone hide himself in secret places that I shall not see him, saith the Lord? Do not I fill heaven and earth, saith the Lord? I have heard what the prophet said, that prophesied lies in my name, saying, I have dreamed. I have dreamed. Is it not their dreams? Is it not? It's a, they prophesy lies. What they are doing to you, they are lies. Some of them are called lying wonders, because you will never know that they are lies. The way they are arranged, so sophisticated, so deep, that you will never know all those things are lies. Who would have told you that a lot of these miracles they are showing you on the screen, they're lies? Will you have understood that? It is wonder. Because I saw it with my eye. I saw it with my eye. Lies. Lies. A particular man in Benin City. So, a man, a young boy, who was living in Lagos, on the screen. And this young boy was sitting on crutches. In the crusade of world, one of these your wonder workers in this country. He said, when did this my neighbor become crippled? Yesterday I saw him. Maybe it's today I didn't see him, and he is crippled over there, sitting on a wheelchair, looking up to man of God, man of God. The man of God came, I command you in the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. This young boy jumped out. Out of the wheelchair. I started walking perfectly. Hey, everybody's clapping. Did you not see with your eyes? Lying wonders. Lying wonders. You are running for miracle for your destruction. Then he confronted the young man. What? Which way did you become crippled? It's business. It's business. They select people from various places to do business with you. Oh, Jesus. The professor lies unto you. How long shall this be in the heart of the prophet? The professor lies, yet they are prophets of the deceit of their own heart. Deceit of their own heart. Some of them have been deceived because demons have deceived them. They really see evil spirits. They really see spirits looking like Jesus coming to them. Yes, that's what God is saying. Which thing to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams, which they tell every man to his neighbor, as their fathers have forgotten me, forgotten my name for Baal. What is the purpose of all these churches now? Great people with all their prosperity and lying wonders, to remove God out of the minds of people. To remove the truth out of the mind of people. God laments because of them. God laments. The prophet that had a dream, let him tell his dream. Let him tell a dream. And he that had my word, let him speak my word faithfully. Praise the Lord. What is the chaff to the wheat, says the Lord? I announce to you, you have come to the prophet that has the word of God. And we shall preach this word of God faithfully unto you. All those chaffs that you have been passing through there, you have been wallowing in them, passing through deception. You have come to the original. The original word of God is here. The original word of God is here. The original Holy Spirit is here. The power of the name of Jesus, that original power is working here. And you shall be transformed. You shall be transformed. Evil shall be destroyed. Righteousness shall cover your life. Praise the Lord. Your God showed you mercy that you're here. When John saw some Pharisees come to him, he said, "Ye brood of vipers, who has wanted you to escape the judgment to come? You sold yourself to evil. You sold yourself to evil workers, and they were ruining your life. Judgment was hanging upon you. Thank God you came here. Thank God you have run to this place. Thank God you have run for refuge to the presence of the Lord. And the Lord shall show you mercy." I say the Lord shall show you mercy. The Lord shall deliver you. He shall break your yokes. He shall remove your limb from hell. Your limb shall go to heaven because you have come to the presence of God. Seek the truth. Seek the Lord, you will find him. Seek the Lord, you will find him. He will set you free. He will loose you from your captivity. That's what God is speaking. That's what the word of God is saying. Yes, it's not my word like as a fire, seeth the Lord, and like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces. Therefore, behold, I am against the prophet, seeth the Lord, that steal my words from one from another, and everyone from his neighbor. Behold, I am against the prophet, seeth the Lord, that use their tongue and say, he said. They use their tongue and say, it's God. Kai, this deception is heavy. You remember a lady in Lagos? Maybe some of you don't know. I knew. This is an evil. It's an evil prophet. And this one showed that he's a child. He's a prophet of God. Jesus himself is the one living inside her. And so when you come near, it's from Cross River. But she would twist her tongue. Oh, my son, I love you, my daughter. They twist their tongue. I'm telling you, these people. You're hearing what I'm saying? It's a serious case. Many are in hell already, crying in hell because of them. Many are doomed already, they cannot come back. Many are doomed already. Thank God they are not able to catch everybody. Corrupt Christian ministry in many places. Yes, in the book of Psalm 12, verse 1 to 4. Help, Lord. For the faithful fall from among the children of men. Help, Lord, for the godly man ceases. For the faithful fall from among the children of men. They speak vanity, everyone, with his neighbor, with flattering lips, and with a double heart do they speak. The Lord shall cut off all flattering lips, and the tongue that speaketh proud things. Who have said, with our tongue will we prevail? Our lips are our own. Who is Lord over us? The boast of their tongue. Some of them took bath with honey. According to them, honey and Satan mixed together, so that their tongue should be very sweet. And by their fierce speeches, nice words, they deceive the heart of many. Liars. Their ministry is lies. They tell lies. They testify lies about what God is doing through them. Were you there with them when he said, when he went to London? This is what happened in London. Were you there? They give various testimonies that are not true. They gather them. And you are hearing. You are hearing. You say, hey, he's a wonderful man of God. That's their practice. They give lying glories to themselves. They will tell you who they are. They bear lying titles. Apostle. Bishop. Archbishop. Are there other new names now? Eh? Do you know other new names that have come up? They bear great names. A small boy who just came up now. Which church do you have that you carry a big name? Do you know who is an apostle? Do you know who is an apostle? Did Timothy call himself apostle? Do you know who is an apostle? Do people dare anyhow claim this title of apostle? You just claim it upon yourself. Claim it. And they don't know that they're offending. They don't know. So, since he has become apostle, little person like that say, I'm a bishop, because he wants to join a rank of people. He wants to join a rank so that when he speaks, they say a bishop is there. It's a bishop who said it. As if that title gives him authority higher than the Bible. That's what they do to confuse you. Yes. They make gains in their ministry. Gains. Philippians chapter 3. Philippians. That ministry is established for gain. Do you remember that young man in Ghana that went and collected that power and was paying tribute to the man, that herbalist? Do you remember the story? He didn't pay the man his salary, because I don't know what happened. And the man came to the church and said, give me back my power. You have not paid salary for long now. And eventually the man went to bring policemen into the matter. They entered into the church and brought out the thing. Members were seeing captured members. They would have known it long. Did you see the type of babbling style that man had? If the members were true, they would have known that only area boys bob their hair like this one, like this man. They don't even know anything. You would have known by their works, you shall know them. If you were true, if you were looking for God, but they were not looking for God. Philippians chapter 3, verse 17 and 18. 17 to 19 rather. Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which walk, so as ye have us for an example. For many walk, of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ, whose God is destruction, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things. Can you see that? Their God is their stomach. The Lord says, I should tell you, you should sow seed. It is his stomach that is saying. They are making gains out of you. Bring your money. Bring your money. Making gains. They established the ministry for money. Some of them went to America. They went with true gospel, but went and changed and started looking for dollar there. The power of dollar changed them in America. And Christianity was traded for dollar. Yes. They exploit their members materially. They treat them into giving offering. Giving, 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 giving. A particular pastor told me this story in Boko. A sound church, a holy church, dedicated. This happened how many years ago now? He said the Pentecostal Fellowship of Nigeria came to his church, came and met him, and said, we are having a special meeting to steer believers to evangelism. Because we want to corporately do evangelism. They have good purpose. But that good purpose is not original. Because the man organizing that is an evil man. So, we want the venue to be in your church. So this person considered, okay, it's for evangelism. It's not doctrine. To steer people to do evangelism. Who knows whether when they come to my church, some of them will remain my members. Who knows? He accepted. So they came. So they started. And they preached very well. Preached well about evangelism, number one. Preached evangelism and said, in the last day, one of the ministers will be coming from Akwa Ibom, who will be raising money for the work of the Lord. All this evangelism will need money. So, eventually, that man arrived. When that man arrived, he was taught, dressed up properly with the powers of money. Powers. His tongue was washed with honey. So when he came and began to speak on money, hey, the money in people's body, wherever that money happens to show, that money is, it will show up. Then he started to do altar call. Yes. Yes, you are here. You can give 2 million for this walk. 2 million, come out, come out. 2 million, everybody, come out. To the shock of this pastor, people were coming out for 2 million. Eh? In my church here. Okay, 1 million, 1 million. People were coming out for 1 million. Uh-uh. The leader of that denomination was to visit Boko. So he was struggling with his members to contribute money to hold that crusade. All he was able to get was 800,000.
He was struggling.
Money was not coming out. But see, 2 million. 1 million. Yes, yes, 500,000, 500,000. You see lines of people. Okay, all right, 100,000, 50,000. So you have that amount of money. I was looking for money. We were looking for money for the work of God. You never gave it. So you have money like that. Do you need this preacher? But was it? Did he have power to speak? Did he have power to speak again? Somebody has taken over his pulpit. He was just watching until even his wife also came out. He said, "Praise the Lord!" I'm saying they will exploit you. They are exploiting the people, impoverishing the people. Armed robbers in pastor's uniform. That's what they're doing there. That's what they're doing there. And this pastor, when he saw this, he called his senior pastor and said, "Hey, something is going on in my church." And the pastor said, "Stop it now. Tell the people, let them not give it. Let them not give it." He labored and labored to stop the people. The people say, "Meet us in the hotel there. Yes, the Lord will bless you. Meet us there." All effort before he will do anything. Many have already gone to give it in the hotel. His struggle only restrained some. Until some will come and say, "Pastor, I didn't know what caused me to do this thing. What? This boy used power. Why will he not use power? You refuse to give money to God. Didn't the Bible say he will give you over to reprobate man?" He gave, refused to. You would have given it to God for holy uses. You kept it. You didn't remember the story of armed robbers who stopped Lazarus' boss on the way and say, "If you know you have not paid your tithes, come out here." And people started coming out. If you know you have paid your tithes, you pay your tithes faithfully to God, go down this way. And they went. He said, "Okay, the rest that have not paid tithes, you are paying it here now." Robbing in good conscience. Since you refuse to give it to God, the Bible says he will give you pockets that have holes. Amen. But that's what they do. They borrow from their members and are not paying again. They give them false hope. They are false prophets. Matthew chapter 7. Matthew chapter 7. I read verse 15. The Bible says, Matthew chapter 7, verse 15. "Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves." Ravening wolves. That's what the Bible says of them. They teach false doctrine. They are false prophets. They give false counseling. They commit immorality. Right in the counseling room, they corner you, their woman. After they are finished, they tell you what to do. "Oh, you are looking for a child?" The stories are many. I'm telling you, women. "You are looking for a child? Okay, God has said I should introduce childbearing for you." The Lord just spoke to me now. I didn't know. I didn't know. God has spoken to me just now. You feel that God is not saying, God is sanctioning immorality. So, That's what they do. Commit immorality. The Lord says, I shall anoint your body, private body, as a woman. And they call the name of the Lord. Do you know that, Lord? Everybody is Lord, including the high court judge. Satan is Lord. Are you hearing me? He said it. He didn't write it. So Satan is Lord. And he said, they go about saying, the Lord told me. The Lord told me. Which Lord? If it's the God of heaven, his ways are pure. His ways are holy. His ways are true. Which Lord? They use the name the Lord to do everything. Tell you lies. Yes. They are satanic in ministry. Simon the sorcerer. Charismatic witchcraft. Yes. In the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 13 to 15. For such are false prophets, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no matter, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. They are deceitful workers, false prophets. Yes. In Revelation chapter 2, verse 20, notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. Jezebel. They are occultic. They enslave the people to Satan. The more people you give to Satan, the more power and anointing you receive. The more people, the more blood you drink, the more anointing works in your life. That's what is happening among them. So they kill. They drink blood. Yes. They deceive them with fierce speeches, nice words. They sacrifice them for power. Kill them. They kill them and be sacrificing for power constantly. They use oil. Demonic oil, handkerchiefs, aprons, water, blood, salt, and other substances in place of faith in the name of Jesus and in the word of God. They perform lying wonders. And so have filled Christendom with false believers, all ungodliness and moral decay. That is what they have achieved. They are there. In the last days, some shall depart from the faith and give heed to seducive spirit and doctrines of devils. They have departed from the faith. They are not children of Satan. They are teaching doctrines of devils. Prosperity all the way. Doctrine of devils. When they give you handkerchief, they say the handkerchief will work. Just go and keep it carefully in the house. Go and keep it carefully in the house. Anytime there is a problem, run to that thing, pick it. They don't tell you to confess your sin. They don't tell you to examine your life, whether you've offended God. They don't tell you that. What a deceit. Just carry comb. If you're going for an interview, comb your head backward and comb it forward. And keep this comb well. That, yes. Who are you talking to? Are they children of God? Everybody here is a child of God. Who told you? Jesus said, have I not chosen you 12, but one is a devil? If among the disciples of Jesus, one is a devil, one is of the devil, are you thinking that all these people are of God, that you have given children of God comb, and they are no more to repent of their sins? They are no more to repent of their sins. They are no more to check their lives. Oh, foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you that ye should turn from the faith and begin to follow false preachers, corrupt preachers that have left the path of God like Balaam? They have left the path of God and they're going after money. You have gone after them for your doom, for your destruction. You're following them. You're keeping comb in your house for your judgment in the eternal, because that comb is an idol. Did comb die for you? Did comb shed the blood for you? Is there blood in that comb? For without the shedding of blood, there's no remission. No man cometh to the Father except through Jesus. And if faith is what works, for without faith, it is impossible to please him. Is it faith in a comb? Is that faith in a comb? Is that faith in an image? Is that faith in an apron? I'm saying that's the decay that is going on now. That's where Christianity really, the Christianity went down. And the Lord says, I will do a new thing. I say, I will do a new thing. You are now in the headquarters of the new thing that the God of heaven has begun to do. Holiness revival movement worldwide. It's going to all the world. It's going to all nations. We're getting over to about 40 nations now. It's moving. It's moving. It's moving. A new thing altogether. Delivering the people, giving them life. As a result, we are saying, be sure we're giving you pure Christian ministry. As you come here, know it, we're giving you pure Christian ministry. And all you who have come here and are ministering must give the people pure Christian ministry. In Isaiah chapter 52, verse 11. Isaiah 52, verse 11. Depart ye. Depart ye, go ye out from dens, touch no unclean thing, go ye out of the midst of her, be ye clean that bear the vessels of the Lord. Get out of the worldly church, get out of the worldly ministry, depart from them. Yea, that bear the vessels of the Lord in Christian ministry, be clean, be holy, be righteous, be ye clean that bear the vessels of the Lord. In Romans chapter 12, I read verse 1 and 2. Romans chapter 12. Verse 1 and 2. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. It's a plea. Pleading. God is pleading. Apostle Paul, in the power of the Holy Ghost, is pleading. Another Paul, over holiness revival movement, is pleading. That as you have come here, present your life, man and woman, a living sacrifice. Holy. Acceptable unto God. Holy sacrifice. This is how you can render reasonable service unto God. You pastors who have come, ministers of the gospel, we are pleading with you. Leave this old wine preachers. Old wine preachers. Jesus has created the new wine. Come to drink the new wine. Flow with the new wine. The new wine is the good wine. It is the wine that came later. People will ask, but why didn't this come up earlier? They had asked the governor of the feast. Every man first will bring forth the good wine before the bad. And when men are drunk, then the bad one can come. But you put the bad wine, you first set the bad wine first. And your people are drunk, and now you're bringing the good wine. Why did you do like that? The bridegroom is not even aware. It's the work of God. Satan came before Jesus came. So, the old wine has been in oppression, but the new wine has come. The old ministry system has been in oppression, but now a new ministry system has come for you. Old mentors have taken over and led captive and led you captive. But now the Lord has raised up new mentors to lead you to righteousness, to victory, to success. I beseech you therefore, conform. Follow this path. Come to this ministry. Let it be like that in your ministry. Show it in your church, in your denomination, wherever you are as a minister. Righteousness will rule you. Truth should rule you. Don't mind that the people may leave. Those people living are demons. They're the demons that are there to take you to hell. But if you see them leave, it's because light has come and darkness must go away. Otherwise, if they're looking for God, they will come back. Don't mind their living. Don't mind what you suffer. A pastor in Living Faith, who is one of us here now, when he came out from the Living Faith, the Lord told him, go and start a ministry. I'll be with you. He started it and is suffering, pulling forward. My wife was telling me, I look at this man and I'm pitying him. The Lord smote her heart and said, do you know the damage he did for me in Living Faith? Whatever suffering he's suffering now, is it equal to the judgment he did there? Leave him alone to suffer. In the appropriate time, there shall be a difference in his life. Whatever suffering you may encounter in this new life, don't mind. If that will be enough to comfort God's heart for the damage you did for him when you were among those dark people, When you were taken to the dark continent, when you went underwater and collected, you slept in the water. You remember? If this will suffice God, fine. But affliction shall not continue. You are just so that after that ye have suffered a while, the Lord shall visit you. The Lord shall raise you up. The Lord shall advance your life. The Lord shall establish you. And you and your members shall have the hope of eternal life. So, the acceptable ministry is the ministry of holiness. In 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 to 21. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 to 21. The Bible tells us here saying, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure. Having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man, therefore, purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good works. Those that serve the living God must be pure and holy, for their service to be acceptable unto him. It is a sin for any minister, any Christian leader, to raise up corrupt workers to serve the Holy God in any area of ministry. It's a sin to you to have in your choir ladies that are not properly dressed with their tights exposed to corrupt the people for immorality. It's a sin to you. It's a sin. That ministry is doomed. That ministry, God is not there. Your fasting and prayer, the Lord does not take them. Because of the dressing of your choir members, you take polluted things to present to God. You bring polluted things to the altar. Women that the breasts are out, they put on the hair of demons. You bring them to minister to God, you shall be punished. Listen to what God says. Can you do that to a human ruler? Can you do that to your governor? To set before him a blind thing like that? Like those people playing your musical instrument that have bob their hair and leave coffin on top. Are you going to? Is that the type you will present to your president if he visits your place? If the president is to come to your church, is it this woman with tight-fitting trousers that you are going to present to the president of the earth that you are presenting corrupt workers? Corrupt workers, evil workers, decayed before the God of heaven to come and sing for him, to come and minister to him. Look at it in the book of Malachi. Malachi, I read chapter 1, verse 6 to verse 8. A son honoreth his father, and a servant his master. If then I be a father, where is my honor? And if I be a master, where is my fear? Saith the Lord of hosts, unto you, O priests, O ministers, that despise my name. And ye say, wherein have we despised thy name? Where ye offer polluted bread upon mine altar. And ye say, wherein have I polluted thee? In that ye say, the table of the Lord is contemptible. And if ye offer the blind for sacrifice, is it not evil? And if ye offer the lame and the sick, is it not evil? Offer it now unto thy governor. Will he be pleased with thee, or accept thy person? Saith the Lord of hosts. Women that are not properly dressed, that tear their skirts, are the ones climbing your altar. Coming with bare head. You are not a minister. God doesn't know you. He said you're abusing him. Holy God, Holy God, Holy God. Everybody called his holiness three times. Can you bring people that don't know him to serve him? Can you bring demonized people to serve him? Can you bring naked people to serve him? Can you bring polluted people to serve him? Can you bring sinners, idolatrous people, and promote them and say, hey, look at them. They're not your preachers. They're not your elders in your church. Adulterers. People that commit immorality like dogs are the ones who are bringing to the house of God. Let that church collapse. It's an abuse to God. Holy God. Holy God. You didn't hear of the seraphims that worship God, the cherubims. You didn't hear how they worship God with two wings. They cover their face because of the holiness of God. And fly about, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which art, which is, and which is to come. You know, you didn't hear? Holy ones. The Lord is holy. The Lord is holy. The Lord is holy. The creator of the world is holy. The maker of mankind is holy. The great one is holy. Jesus is holy, holy, holy. That holy thing that shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of the Highest. You abuse his name. You abuse his name. You pollute his church with witches and wizards. You give Jezebel a chance to come in and control the people of God. Pollute them with witchcraft. Watch, take heed unto the church which the Lord has bought with his own blood. Don't give that church to sinners to rule. Don't say they are your children. Ministry is not for you or your children. Did you hear of the Moses' children taking a prominent role in the war? Someone said, my children did not follow my path. So where are you thinking you must force them? Would not someone have taken his children and put them in position? He would not corrupt this gospel, but you corrupt it. You and your family corrupt the gospel of Jesus. You take children who are not born again and put them in position to play music. Play music for demons or for human beings. Play music, is it to the hearing of Satan or to the hearing of the Holy God? You have contempted me. You have despised my name. Therefore, this must not be done. Check it out. Check it out. Don't give holy service to dogs. People who are sinners, don't give them holy service. Don't respect them by service. Those who serve before God as his ministers, such as the choristers, the ushers, cleaners, musicians, preachers, teachers, prayer leaders, prayer warriors, those working in the media, electronics, yeah, electricians, and all kinds must be holy. Must be holy. Don't run to open the chapters when there are no people to run them. Don't be fast. We're not doing competition here. Don't be fast to open a unit until you have a leader for them. God didn't create man until he had created all things required for man. Don't open a chapter until you have somebody fit for it. Don't open a unit until you have somebody qualified for it. We're going by quality, not quantity. Quantity, a little level will level the whole lump. That's the work of God. They must be holy. There must be examples. All categories of ministers serving God must be vessels unto honor, respected by God and man, cherished by God and man. They must be pure in conscience. For our rejoicing is this, the testimony of our conscience, that in simplicity and godly sincerity, not with fleshly wisdom, but by the grace of God, we have had our conversation in the world, and more abundantly to you, world, the testimony of our conscience. Let our conscience remain clean and clear. Man and woman, you and your husband, do you have a clear conscience doing the work of God there? You fight yourself, grudge against yourself, keep balance against yourself and your chapter leaders. You are abusing the work of God, and the Lord will pass you through judgment. Why didn't you report yourself that Satan has taken over you and that you can no more bear the vessel of the Lord? That you are living in malice, you are living in fighting, and you are still leaders. You are still a leader. The table of the Lord is contemptible to you. You say the table of the Lord is contemptible. That's why you can do anything and still go out there. That's not my, that can anybody hide himself in secret place that I cannot see? Show your faithfulness and report yourself. That will show you mercy. For mercy goes with truth. Mercy goes with truth. Your wife is too tough. Let us know. Let's join hands together to handle her prayerfully, in wisdom, in counsel, and see how the Lord will serve her for your better ministry. Your husband, hey, like that. Is she a member? Is he a member? Let us know. Let's know how to handle it, so that you can have purity to serve the Lord and make heaven, than to be serving the Lord in sin. Serving the Lord and you're not true, you're not original. The reason why you're not staying home is because home is not fine. That's why you're moving from place to place and say you're going for crusade. Home, you have not, the home is burning with fire because sin is there, Satan is there, and you are leaving home and going. Has all things been done for the peace of that home and peace didn't come? You must be sound in doctrine. Preach the word. In the book of 1 Corinthians, sound in doctrine. Yes, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season, reproof, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. With all longsuffering and doctrine. Titus chapter 2 verse 1. But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine. Don't avoid restitution when people who need restitution are there. I don't want to embarrass them. Is Jesus you want to embarrass? You don't want that man to feel that you are fighting him. Have you taken that man and handled him privately? That you do your restitution? Can't you preach it publicly? That other people should know the doctrine of restitution? Was it not the Holy Ghost that gave you the word to speak, but you are avoiding because of man. Overcome the fear of man. Be sound in doctrine. Yeah. Lay hold on eternal life. Lay hold on eternal life. 1 Timothy chapter 6. I read from verse 11 to 16. But thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called, and hast professed a good profession before many witnesses. I give thee charge in the sight of God, who quickeneth all things, and before Christ Jesus, who before Pontius Pilate witnessed a good profession, that thou keep this commandment without spot, unrebukable, until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ, which in his times he shall show who is the blessed and only potentate, the King of kings and the Lord of lords, who only had immortality dwelling in the light, which no man can approach unto, whom no man hath seen nor can see, to whom be honor and power everlasting. And lay the thunderous voice of the people say, amen. That is it. Go and preach this thing. Don't change in Europe. Don't change in America. Don't change in all Asian countries. Don't change in all parts of Nigeria, Africa. Don't change. That's the word. Everybody say, don't change.
Don't change.
Say it again.
Let
our coordinators stand up so that you will tell them they must not change. This thing they're hearing here, if you see your coordinator changing, let us hear. Let us know. In case the bullet of the devil has got him. No change. Everybody tell them, don't change.
Don't change.
Say it again to them.
Say
it the third time. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Seek the glory and rewards that come from God only. Don't seek your name. Those who are seeking their names, they have gone. They are going to be looking for their name now, and they shall not find it. Because the gospel of Jesus is not for the glory of man. It's for the glory of God. Be dead to serve and seek God's glory only. Seek the reward that comes from God only, and that thing shall follow. That's God. Jesus said, I seek not my own honor. I seek not my own glory, but the glory of him that has sent me. There is one that seeketh my glory, even the Father. As I seek his own, he will seek mine. As I give all the glory to him, he will give me the glory due unto me. That is it. Be strong for the battle. For we wrestle. We wrestle. We fall. In Ephesians chapter 6, I read verse 10 to verse 14 to 13. Finally, my brethren, Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand, stand. Yes. Satan is working so hard against this ministry, Holiness Revival Movement worldwide, to destroy it. Why? Because of the word holiness it bears, which signifies God. Where he sees holiness, he wants to mess it up. That's why he's fighting to desecrate this place. He's sending agents. Watch them out in children's section. Watch out those teachers that are teaching. Watch out all those teachers, just children too, that they don't bring initiation to these children, to cause children rising up from here to become stubborn, wayward witches and wizards. Watch out. It is a battle. Watch out to those who come to do our work in the kitchen here. Watch out for every man, every woman, to see who she is, who he is. That the devil does not send her to pollute our food. Watch out. Watch out in prayer. Watch out practically to see who is here. How is he here? Watch out. Watch out over every woman coordinator who has access to the people to ensure she's not a witch. Trying to turn the people away from God. Turn the people away from righteousness. Watch out. Check every character. Check it out. Watch out at every coordinator to ensure that he is not a self-willed man employed by the devil to scatter the people, to divide the people. Watch out. The devil wants to do harm to holiness movement. We shall not give him way. We shall not give him chance. And you, the Satan has sponsored to come to holiness movement as your job to pull it down, the Lord shall bring forth your nakedness. The hand of our God shall be heavy upon your life. Shame and destruction shall be your portion. You tell the devil you repent. Tell the devil you repent and that you will never join him anymore. That's what you have to do. You will be discovered. I say your sins shall find you out. For the Lord shall speak about you. We shall know you. We shall know you. We shall spot you out. And you shall be dealt with accordingly. The Lord says, I should tell you, as you succeeded in destroying other churches, it's not holiness movement. Holiness movement, the Lord says, I should tell you, it is his own ministry. You cannot succeed. You cannot succeed in the name of Jesus. If you have come here for your salvation, you're welcome. If you have come here for your deliverance, you're welcome. But don't come here as a messenger of Satan to do harm to anybody. Otherwise, you will carry sorrow. That's what God says, I should tell you. It grieves the heart of God that you're pulled down many churches. Satan is against this church because of what God has said about Pastor Paul Ricker. He wants to disprove it. He wants to say no to it. He wants to say never, it will not happen, but it shall happen. What God has said about me shall stand forever. Amen. Satan is against this movement because of the revelations of Sister Linda. He wants to prove that he can never walk. That is a lie. He has used various ways. It's not working. To cause this revelation from going out to men, to block it, to pull it down, as he has done to other people, to silence it. It shall not work. This revelation shall work forever. Until the rapture. Until the rapture. The purity of this message shall be preserved. Hallelujah. yes, Satan is against this ministry because it is the hope of God for this present time. The heart of God is upon it. And Satan wants to ruin it. Why? Because the eyes of God is upon it. And the Lord has said he will jealously protect this ministry. He will jealously keep it. Watch it. There's no backsliding for this ministry. Watch it. This ministry shall welcome Jesus coming in the rapture. We shall welcome Jesus coming in the rapture. This ministry, we shall not backslide. It shall not close down. The Lord has said it. It shall be so. Yes. If Satan feels he has not seen wonders, he will see it now. Because this is end time battle. And the Lord has released great grace upon us. I said the Lord has released great grace upon us. And you who have not gotten this grace, receive great grace in this ministry. Receive great grace in this ministry. Receive great grace in this ministry. Human beings everywhere testify, the Lord has served me. The Lord has helped me through all and more. The Lord has said, Satan said, what? I will block it. You won't block it. More are still coming. More are dancing their way to holiness. More are asking questions on their way to holiness. Hallelujah! 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 Therefore, stand and fight. It is a battle. We're in the battlefield. This is the end time. The game shall soon be over. We will win. We have determined to win. Our leader is Jesus. The captain of our salvation is Jesus. By him we have won. Stand up and shout, we have won. Open your mouth and worship the Lord. Open your mouth and rejoice. We shall stand uncorruptible. We shall stand uncorruptible. We shall stand righteous and perfect. Righteous and perfect. Daily, all the days of our life, until the rapture appears.
The message you have just listened to is a production of Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide. Holiness Revival Movement Worldwide is a non-denominational ministry that is given to the propagation of Christ's righteousness and holiness in churches and nations of the world through crusades, revival meetings, production and spread of holiness literature and materials. For other spiritual materials, messages, or inquiries, contact us on 0816-902-3948 or 0805-683-4323. You can also reach us through our email address, holinessrevivalmovement@gmail.com. God bless you.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Hallelujah. Jesus, I believe in you. You are my Lord and Savior. I believe in you. You are the living Savior. I believe.
I believe.
my Lord and Savior. I believe in you. You are the living Savior. You came from heaven. You chased me with your blood. You are my Lord and my Savior. You left your throne above and took up the form of a servant for my sin. I believe in you,
'cause you are my Lord and Savior.
You are my Lord and Savior.
Jesus, I believe in you.
I believe in you,
Lord, 'cause you are
a living Savior.
Jesus, I believe. I believe in you. You are the living Savior. I believe in you. I love you, Lord.
I love you.
I believe.
Savior.
Jesus, I believe.